Would you all please stand for the national anthem? For this evening, celebrating the graduation of the 1998 Craigslea State High Seniors. We would like to thank Mr. Terry Hansen, Alderman for the Ward of Marchant, Mr. Clive Campbell, Senior Officer representing Mr. Tom Mould, who's the District Director for Geebung District of Education Queensland, Mrs. Robin Orlicky, Parents and Citizens President for Craigslea State High School, teachers, parents and supporters for attending this ceremony. We offer an apology for Mr. Sullivan, who has been called to Parliament, and wish a warm, happy birthday to Alderman Hanson. Tonight marks the culmination of 12 years of schooling for our graduating seniors, and we offer our personal congratulations to these students. I would now call Mr. Massingham, Principal of Craigslea High School, to address you.
Justina, Mr. Campbell, Mr. Hanson, Mrs. Orlicky, other invited guests, fellow staff, ladies and gentlemen, and students. Tonight we come to the end of another Year 12 school year. After 12 long years of education, the students before us leave secondary school begin a new phase of their life. Some are very excited about the prospects, while others are apprehensive about their future. I hope that we at Craigslea have prepared them so that they become worthwhile members of our society. During their time at school, they've had their highs and lows, successes and failures. They've made friends and had friendships broken, liked aspects of school while they disliked others. This period of their lives has given them an insight into what is likely to happen now that they are leaving school. The big difference for them is that the support personnel, parents, teachers, guidance officers, chaplains, and other friends will not always be as readily available as they have been for the last 12 years. These Year 12s were in Year 9 when I arrived at Craigslea. And I've noticed significant developments in them as they progress through to Year 12. They've taken on many significant roles this year in the Student Council and other committees. The school is thankful for the work done by those who initiated and organised the Multicultural Day in August. Many of you have been excellent leadership models for the rest of the school. I hope that you continue to use these skills in the next mode of your life. Many of these students have been involved in the school's extracurricular activities. For instance, the instrumental music program has benefited greatly from the contribution of the 15 Year 12s who have participated in practices and performances throughout the year. We're all looking forward to the release of the senior certificates, and I'm sure that this group of students will uphold Craigslea's excellent academic reputation. I hope they all receive an offer for the course or employment of their choice. In closing, I say thank you for everything that you have contributed to Craigslea during your time here. I hope that we've given you an education which has suited your needs. Craigslea High will celebrate its 25th anniversary in the year 2000. That's not far away. And we look forward to seeing you back here for those celebrations. I noticed that we've got a number of past students here tonight for these celebrations. So let's hope that that 25th anniversary is an attraction for our past students, and we see many of them back here. I'd now like to introduce Mr. Campbell, who, as Justina said, is here representing Mr. Mole, the District Director for G-Bunk, to come forward and say a few words before we present the graduation certificates. Thank you, Mr. Campbell.
Thank you very much for the invitation to be here tonight, and I'm so delighted to see that there are so many people here. In fact, it's overwhelming. We seem to not have enough seats. But this occasion is one where I think I've got to apologise for starters, and I hate doing that. My district director did want to be here tonight. We have a busy schedule usually at the end of the year with functions like this, and it has been impossible for him to be in two places at once. So on behalf of Mr. Mould, I'd apologise to the Craigslea community. However, I have attended these functions before, and I do understand the value of these occasions to the community, and particularly to the departing Year 12s. I'd congratulate on behalf of the G-Bung District all of those Year 12 students who are graduating here from Craigslea High tonight. And I think I should pay particular attention at this early stage of the evening to those who are going to receive rewards for their outstanding efforts this year. It's particularly heartening for me to see this school still conducting an award ceremony such as this to recognise achievement and excellence in education. I think so too often we underestimate the quality of some of the products, so to speak, that emerges from our state school system. I'm constantly amazed by the attributes and the qualities of many of our students who leave our state system, and I think they are up there with many of those of our other students who exit from the private system. For those students who have obtained wonderful results and have achieved outstanding her performance has been outstanding this year, I say to you, continue on and make the best of the opportunities that are in front of you. There are an enormous amount of available options now to students with talent and students who many of you are going to see tonight who have outstanding talent. I think a night like this is also a very good opportunity to pay tribute to the many people along the way who have nurtured our Year 12s to where they are today. There's no doubt many a parent has been and made many sacrifices and has certainly done as much as they can to make sure that their student is given the best possible opportunity to education. And we must not forget that parents and generally families have been a significant contributor to those many students tonight who are going to receive awards and graduate from Year 12. Not the least, the teachers along the way who have also had a fair hand in the nurturing process and have enabled many of our students to achieve skills that I certainly didn't achieve in my lifetime at school. Reflecting on this occasion this afternoon, I do recall about 30 odd years ago, sitting where most of the Year 12s were, here tonight, and my era, there I came through when logarithms and things like slide rules were the go, when we had to do calculations. I don't think many of our students even know what they are today, and we have at our disposal now sophisticated devices and a curriculum which has a sophistication like we've never seen before. So things have changed dramatically in my time, and I ponder on what might be the situation in another 30 years. However, a few things haven't changed in my lifetime, and I'd leave these as messages for some of our graduating Year 12s. I've found that your schooling becomes a fundamental part of your whole lifelong education, and that's what we're talking about these days. You move from a schooling scene into an education world that continues for the rest of your working life, if not the rest of your life. I found that hasn't changed. I've also found that many Year 12 here tonight should understand that the relationships you build will probably live with, will probably remain with you for the rest of your life, and the building of partnerships and relationships throughout school becomes a significant thing in your life from here on, and certainly has been part of a valuable part of your schooling. The other thing that seems to me that becomes very important to us all tonight even, and a very important significant part as an outcome, would be to appreciate and value life itself. And it's nothing more evident, I think, as we move into Schoolies Week, that becomes a very much a prominent feature in the minds of our Year 12s. The respect for others and to appreciate the physical well-being we have should be one of the prime things that is in your mind even tonight as we graduate here. In conclusion, I would congratulate the organisers of this evening. Certainly pay tribute to the performances here at Craigslea High School, because I do know from my work that the level of academic achievement at this school is up there with the best, and I also know that some of the teaching here is up there with the best. So I would thank those who have had a contribution tonight, and particularly a contribution along the way to the graduating Year 12s. May I wish you all a safe, happy Christmas vacation, and I trust that you all have a Merry Christmas, and to all those awardees tonight, my special congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell, and Mr. Massingham. An important aspect of this evening is a presentation of the graduands to the assembled people, where they'll receive a graduation certificate and along with a small gift. With our increasing student population, presenters of the certificates and gifts will split into two groups. Mr. Massingham, Mr. Campbell, Ms. Cavallaro, and Ms. Sloss. Would you please come onto the stage area to present the seniors with their certificates? Ms. Roseanne Cavallaro and Ms. Janelle Sloss will be reading the graduates' names out to the assembly. It is with pleasure that I ask the graduating seniors of 1998 to stand.
The stage to present the first section. Roshika Akil, Nicola Alexander, and David Allen. Benjamin Amos, Naomi Anderson, Levi Baker, and Michael Barton.
Mark Beaton, Miriam Byers, Renee Bell and Rowan Bellingham. Laurel Blessman, Stephen Burke, Heather Barry and Samuel Brown. Natalie Bray, Claire Bricknell, Pamela Broadhurst and Michael Brown. Alana Carson, Cheryl Carson, Casey Carter and Amy Serikovicius. Eric Chan, Nathan Chattleborough, Melissa Clark and Emma Cummings. Jennifer Costello, Tom Cowley, Kevin Cross and Eric Del Rosario. Simon Denman, Mark DeGars, Leela Devine and Simone Du. Carl Donaldson, Christopher Downey, Peter Drew and Alina Dumbrell. Barbara Edgar, Todd Evans, Tasha Ferguson and Matthew Flannery. Michelle Ford, Justin Gaffney, Kate Gilder and Filippo Grasso. Amber Hare, Catherine Hall, Christopher Hall and Claire Hamilton. Samantha Hansen, Douglas Harrison, Luke Harvey and Freya Helkers. Bryn Holland, Tanya Holmes, Elizabeth Cooper and Kevin Huang. Natasha Hunt, Natasha Islin, Christy Jacobs and Shelley Johns. Megan Jones, Sandy Jordan, Adrian Coit and Amy Lai. Samika Lal, Tony Lau, Josh Laws and Eric Lee. Jason Lee, Peter Lever, Alan Lau and Simon Lee King.
Mr. Campbell, Mrs. Orlicky, and Ms. Cavallaro. I will now ask Mr. Fishburne, Ms. Tromans, Mr. Hampson, and Ms. Slott to come onto the stage area and for Ms. Cavallaro to recommence reading the graduates' names.
Austin Lund, Sarah Jane Mail, Tony Mann, Lucy Marnie. Helen Maders, Rebecca Moore. Anna McChrystal, Lauren McDonald. Kirsten McIntosh, Rebecca McNamara, Adam Mead and Alicia Miles. Alina Morton, Ryan Muller, Stephen Mertaz, Catherine Much. Yodi Nuku, Stephen O'Donnell. Maya Agawa, Cherie Orlicky, Chris Osborne, Lucas Ostrowski.
Mark Pears, Martin Peterson, Leo Phillips. Samantha Pittard, Nathan Pohl, Kylie Pratt Curtis, Bethany Quigg. Anna Radevska, Vindy Aran, Zoe Ray. Stacey Rivers, Amanda Robinson, Justin Russell. Emily Saker, Nicole Saliba, Tony Searles, Natasha Chandel. Sims Reeves, Aaron Smith, Sarah Snell. Sarah Spiring, Matt Stenrup, Trent Stevenson, James Stewart. Kimberly Stewart, Alyssa Sutherland, Aaron Seitz, Sarah Simmons. T. Tan, Laura Taylor, Melanie Teshin King, Rebecca Thompson. Louise Thorpe, Louise Truen, Betty Sauer, Andrew Vandermeer. Brendan Beach, Tyson Farley, Luke Weston, Mark Williamson. Alexandra Wynn and Rebecca Yeo.
Seniors, please be seated.
Thank you to our presenters and thank you to Ms. Cavallaro and Ms. Schloss. The valedictory speech is an address written by a senior student that comments on the school and educational experiences. I would now ask Mim Byers to come forward and present her address.
Invited guests, parents, teachers and students. I can still remember the first big difference I noticed when I came to Craigslea High School in Year 8. It wasn't the strangeness of having to travel to different classes. It wasn't all the scary teachers. It wasn't the fact that we weren't the biggest in the school like we were in primary school. The first thing I noticed when I came to Craigslea High School in 1994 was how big the sausage rolls were. In Year 8, everything seemed so huge and strange. Do you remember how we seemed to do all our lessons in the same block, the Year 8 centre? I've always wondered why that was. Maybe it was because they were ashamed of these puny, pimply little kids. Maybe they thought we weren't house trained. Maybe they thought we'd get stepped on, or maybe they thought we'd get lost, which is probably closer to the truth. We had a Year 8 camp, which for one of the groups wasn't the best of experiences. It rained and all the tents leaked. And we all remember Justin and his little swim in the Brisbane River. But Justin and all of us managed to survive into Year 9. And then Mr. Massingham arrived. And with him the wonderful renditions of Advance Australia Fair during assembly, which we all enjoyed singing to, didn't we? In Year 9, we finally had got used to everything and were no longer confined to the Year 8 block. We were considered real people. There were now students who were smaller than us. In Year 10, we were the head of the junior school. We thought we knew everything and could cope with all our exams and assignments by doing them the night before. Then, Year 11 hit us. And it dawned on us the importance of school, the responsibility we had for our education, and the fact that maybe we couldn't leave assignments and study to the night before. Finally, after 4 long years, we moved into Year 12. There was no one else to look up to. This was it. We were the ones that the teachers had told us about years and years before when we asked if our assignments had been marked. I haven't marked your assignments yet. I've had lots of Year 12s to do, and as you know, they take priority. We also found out that that was just a really good excuse on the teachers' behalf, because this year they told us that they were making Year 8 papers, and you know how important that is. So, we're finally here, at the end of Year 12, and we've grown from this big to this big, but the sausage rolls are still huge. What are the things that have remained the same over the years? Friendships, and some of these will last all our lives. Homework, we couldn't get away from it for 5 whole years. We've also lived through 5 years of assembly, some of us hoping we wouldn't be the ones called up at the end by Mr. Fishburne. Deputies, principals, guidance officers, and teachers have come and gone, but one thing remains the same. Mr. Fishy and Little Judy. Let's remember what we did this year as the student leaders of this school. We had a leadership camp in which we got to know each other as well as ourselves and even managed to have fun doing it. There was the raucous effort, which, as usual, required enormous commitment, and it paid off with Craigslea getting into the finals and receiving the Science Award. In the academic field, many of our students have excelled in maths and science competitions. We achieved well in the arts, receiving the Minister's Award for Excellence. On the music scene, our musicians have enriched the school in many ways through concerts, competitions and performances. As well as this, we participated in both inter and intra-school sport, with the sports committee helping to train future sportsmen and women with the handball and basketball competitions. The Buddy program has meant that we have taken responsibility for ensuring that the Grade 8 introduction to the school is a little less traumatic. And let's not forget one of the major events of the year, Multicultural Day, a celebration of the diversity, not only of Craigslea, but of Australia. Through all these achievements, we hope that we are leaving the school a better place. As our thank you to the educational home we have enjoyed for the years we have spent here. We are all individuals, but during our years together, we have developed into a cohesive and supported group with a strong identification with a school that has tolerated our differences and equipped us to face a challenging future. And that's it. There is no more. We've reached the end of our school lives. We say thank you to the staff who have helped us for the past 5 years. We thank our parents. We appreciate your support. And finally, we thank all our friends. We've shared good times together. We've helped each other out. Some of us may drift apart, but we will never forget these 5 years which end tonight and that shaped our lives. We stand on the end of the springboard, and we dive into an unknown future. In conclusion, let us remember some famous words of Martin Luther King, and it's not "I had a dream." His words were, "Free at last, free at last."
Thank you, Mim, for those words. You have given us an insight into you and your fellow students and their memories of their educational years. A tradition that has been in existence for a number of years is a presentation to the school of a gift from the graduating class. All of you have passed the 1996 seniors gift to the school, namely the honour board, appearing on the left-hand back wall as you leave. And this lectern was presented for the 1997 seniors. This year, Mark Beaton will be presenting the gift, and I ask Mr. Massingham and Mark Beaton to come forward, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, honored guests and graduates. My job this evening is to present the gift to Mr. Massingham from this year's senior class. The gift is an aerial photograph of the school, which was not ready for tonight. But we do have an envelope containing the cheque for the gift, which I'll now hand to Mr. Massey. Yeah.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Year 12. Yes, there is an aerial photograph that has been taken at the school, and it is unfortunate that the person who had taken the photograph said, yes, it will be ready, but unfortunately it's not. But it will be put on public display in the office, so that for future visitors, just as people can see that this lectern was given to the school by the 1997 Year 12s, it will be made quite obvious to any of our visitors that that particular photograph was given by the 1998 Year 12s. So thanks very much for that. Can I just say a few other thank yous, please, while I'm up here? I thank the Year 12s for their contribution. Can I say thank you to Tom Turvey, who's our special events coordinator, and this is a special event. Tom's done a lot of work in organising this. To Roseanne and Janelle, who are our Year 12 coordinators, for the work that they've done in helping in the organisation of this particular evening. Mem, thanks very much for that valedictory. Yes, it did bring back a few memories. The formal committee, the group of Year 12s who have assisted, your contribution has been valued. To our official guests, Mr. Campbell, Mr. Hampson, thanks very much for coming along tonight. It's only short, but it is a very important evening. Some of you would have heard Mr. Hoey. I tell you what, he's standing up here trying to think. It starts with a H, ends with a Y. Yes, Mr. Hoey. It's not as if I don't run into him regularly. Maybe I know too many people, I don't know. But then again, it might be a sign of age. I'm not sure about that either. Mr. Hoey and his chamber group, the office staff for their assistance in the collecting of money, preparing of program and so on. And also a special word of thanks to the Year 11s who have assisted those people serving the food out the front, the people acting as the ushers as the students walk down the steps, to Lucas and Justina for their work as the chairpersons. And some of you might hear a bit of noise behind me. Yes, there is a concert band preparing to, and I'll say thank you to them before they even perform. So can I ask you to show your appreciation of all those people who have had something to do with tonight and say thanks very much.
Thank you, Mark and Mr. Massingham. Ladies, gentlemen and fellow students, the Craigslea Wind Ensemble, most ably led by Miss Christine Jabs, we'll now play two pieces for your pleasure. The two pieces are the theme from Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, and I Had the Time of My Life.
Thank you.
Two graduating seniors have been selected to cut the cake. The cutting of the cake symbolises these two seniors making a wish for all of the seniors of 1998. Once this has been completed, the graduation ceremony comes to an end. But before you leave, we would like to thank the teaching and ancillary staff who assisted in the ceremony. The sound and lighting team led by Mr. Gunn, the Craigslea Wind Ensemble and the Chamber Group, the Year 11 Chair Gang, Tammy Marshall, Alana Kirkham, Michael Morris and Chris Hanney, all students from Year 11 who have assisted tonight. And lastly and finally, a big congratulations to our graduating seniors of 1998. I would ask Nathan Chattelbaugh and Laurel Blattman to come forward and cut the cake.
You all to participate in the after ceremony serving of the cake, which will be distributed in the area outside the hall. We also remind the seniors and the staff attending the formal to try and arrive at the Brisbane City Hall as close as possible to 7:40 p.m. Thank you from Justina and I, and good evening.
Thank you.